kids here in Ireland have been told in the schools, if they feel faint, they have not to ring their parents, they have to tell the teacher. They're being told to lie to their parents.
They're getting breathing breaks every half an hour. A breathing break.
A bleeding break every half hour. Are you reporting on this, lads? The children in school are getting a breathing break. The God-given right of fresh air. They are getting a breathing break every half hour. How fucking dare they?
Unacceptable.
How long are the people, the parents, going to sit back and allow this?
That they have to have breathing breaks. These are children.
The mainstream media here, the anger is getting voiced and the people are angry at the mainstream media. We've got someone from the Irish Times here.
Dead from the
but they are not reporting on these stories. They're only interested in controversy. They're only interested in fights when the United Opposition's idiots that oppose us for exposing rape and paedophilia. That's all the mainstream media is interested in. They're not interested in telling the truth. The man was telling the story here, Brian, about his children. They were no more interested in that story than the man and the fucking man.
They're only obeying orders, like the
when the lad here went into one of the faces there and told him to back off, the other fella was up with his camera like a hot snot to get pictures because he thought there was going to be a bit of a row there. That's all they're interested in, what sells papers. The truth doesn't sell papers. So why yous are here, lads? If yous think yous are going to get what yous are after, yous ain't. So if you're not here to tell the truth, you're wasting your time.
The thing is,
you just boil the blood of these parents even more.
They would sell loads if they told the truth.
It would be great if they told the truth. They'd get the real stories if they told the truth.
People want.
But they want the truth. Listen to me, if they want the truth, all they have to do is go down to GemmaOdoherty.com and OverdueWorld.com. They're the two stations that's telling the fucking truth, and the only two that's telling the truth.
James Collins Ireland as well, I'm telling the truth here.
James Collins Ireland as well is telling the truth. Most of the people that's standing here, they're on there telling the truth. But the two main ones that was out there through the whole lockdown took a day in was Gemma O'Doherty here at GemmaOdoherty.com and OverdueWorld.com. You want to hear the truth, mainstream media, go on both of them channels and you get the truth. You don't even have to come out here, you'll get the truth on those channels. Because like I said, just as I was driving over here, they've taken down the footage of the two lads committing suicide. Because they can't take living on the streets any longer. Why? Why do you think people, tell me why would they delete that? What do they not want the people to see? Why do they not want the people to see it? But they never deleted the footage of them outside of the hotel. Now not a hostel, hotel. Not a sleeping bag in the doorway. Hotel down the country. I can't remember the name of the place. Can any of you remember where she's standing there? We're going on hunger strike. Clifton Hotel. Shut it down is what you were chanting. One of our aunts alone had kept her fed for 6 fucking months and she was screaming she's going on hunger strike because they didn't like the free food.
Public charge.
And guess what? Guess what Minister for Justice Helen McEntee replied to that? We cannot. Now think of the two men going into the canal and all the ones before them. Helen McEntee's reply to that woman outside of that hotel that she was going to go on hunger strike unless they got a home of their own. They wanted their own front door. And guess what Helen McEntee's reply to them was?
Get in the queue!
No, that's what should have been said. What she said to them is, we cannot allow these people to put our health at risk.
Bums.
That was the reply from Helen McEntee. It's on there for any of you to go and see it. Her reply was, we cannot have these refugees putting their health at risk. But for the Irish and the Polish and the Latvians out there on the street, O'Connell Bridge is open if you want to go in. The only option left to the people on the streets is O'Connell Bridge. But she cannot allow these people that didn't like the food, the Irish food, free food wasn't up to standards, and they wanted a front door of their own. So I told them on the canal, you can take your pick, there's two people willing to transfer with you, you can have either side, and you'll have all the air conditioning you like in the fucking tents down there. We've got a man in a